So hello everyone, we are going to discuss the introduction of the coupling rod in two-cylinder locomotives. Before we understand the coupling rod in the two-cylinder locomotives, first you need to know the hammer blow. We have seen in the last topic that effect of partial balancing of two-cylinder locomotives. I will later explain the coupling rod role. But before, you all know very well that in two-cylinder locomotives, what are the effects of partial balancing? We have done the partial balancing in two-cylinder locomotives. So if I'm talking about the effects of the partial balancing, in two-cylinder locomotives, there are three effects. The first one is variation in tractive force. And the second one is the variation in the sign couple. You all know very well sign couple. The variation in sign couple. And what was the third? The third was hammer blow. Focus on that. What is hammer blow? We all know that hammer blow is nothing but BB omega square, where capital B represent the balance mass, but only that balance mass will be responsible for hammer blow, which is required for reciprocating balancing. Okay, because when I'm talking about the total balancing, we generally do total balancing of the rotating masses, but we generally do partial balancing of the reciprocating masses. In order to requirement of the balancing mass, which is responsible for the reciprocating balancing, that is considered as B. Again, I'm writing here, this is only that balance mass. Only that balance mass will be responsible for hammer blow, which is required for reciprocating balancing. Okay, which is required for reciprocating balancing. So how much amount of mass you are having requirement for reciprocating balancing, you just have to consider that balance mass only. That means you have not to consider rotating balancing. Okay, only that balance mass will be responsible for hammer blow, which is required for reciprocating balancing. Now, what is the role of the coupling rod? Why we have development of the coupling rod? Basically, the coupling rod was introduced to decrease the amount of hammer blow. How can you decrease the amount of hammer blow? Just by decreasing the balance mass requirement. Okay, this balance mass requirement, just to decrease the balance mass requirement, we can decrease the hammer blow. Okay, so that is why, in order to decrease the requirement of the or the amount of hammer blow, we have introduced the coupling rod. What is the role? So basically, it is introduced to decrease the amount of hammer blow just by decreasing the balance mass requirement for reciprocating balancing. Like, overall intention is what? Overall intention is to balance reciprocating masses. Our intention is to balance reciprocating masses. So for reciprocating masses, we are having the balance mass, that is capital B. So, but if you want to reduce this, how can you reduce it? Just by reducing the hammer blow. Okay, so that's why we need to develop the coupling rod. So now you are able to understand what it is. Let me write down here. The coupling rod was introduced. What is the purpose? Basically, it was introduced to decrease the amount of hammer blow. Okay, just by decreasing How can you decrease the amount of hammer block? Just by the balance mass requirement. Focus on that. Just by decreasing the balance mass requirement for what? Balance mass requirement for reciprocating balancing. Reciprocating balancing. How can you decrease the balance mass requirement for reciprocating balancing? Just by splitting the reciprocating balancing between the driving and trailing wheels. Is that clear? So again, I'm saying that the coupling rod is just introduced to decrease the amount of hammer blow just by decreasing the balance mass requirement, which is required for reciprocating balancing, just by splitting the reciprocating balancing between the driving and the trailing wheels. Is that clear? So this was the development from the passenger locomotives to the express locomotives. So you can say this was the development from passenger locomotives to what? Express locomotives. Okay. Sometimes two wheels are coupled, but in the super fast locomotives, there are three wheels are coupled. Okay. So this was the introduction of the coupling rod in the two cylinder locomotives. I hope you will be able to understand. Just remember basic intention of the two cylinder locomotives, coupling rod in the two cylinder locomotives is just to decrease the amount of hammer blow just by decreasing the balance mass requirement for reciprocating balancing, just by splitting the reciprocating balancing between the driving and the trailing wheels. Okay. So I hope you will understand this concept. So thank you.